Hello everyone, I am Vimuda. Today I am going to continue the Mahabharata. As the boon given to Gandhari by Lord Shiva, she gave birth to 100 sons and one daughter. The young daughter name was Dushala. And this young Dushala was married to King Jayadratha of Sindhu. The eldest son of Dhritarashtra and Gandhari was Duryodhan. As soon as Duryodhan was born, he began to bray like an ass. Hearing his cry, all the vultures, eagles, crows began to also cry. A violent storm hit the city of Hastinapuram. Fire broke out in many places in the city. All this natural disaster was caused because of the cry of Duryodhan. Vidura was aware of that. So he said to Dhritarashtra, the wise one said that one member can be abandoned for the sake of the family. For the sake of the village, one family can be abandoned. For the sake of the community, one village can be abandoned. For the sake of saving a soul, everything in the world can be abandoned. Your son is born on this earth to spill its soul. So therefore, I advise you to abandon him. Duryodhan being the firstborn, Dhritarashtra loved him so much. So he did not heed about Vidura's advice. Dhritarashtra began to raise his 100 sons and one daughter with great love and care. One day, Pandu went on a hunting trip. He spotted a dove and a stag wandering in the forest. Pandu aimed and shot 5 arrows in the direction which they are. The stag and the dove fell down. As Pandu went near them, he saw a man and a woman lying there wounded by his arrows. There were a sage named Dama and his wife who amused their forms in the form of a stag and a dove. Unknowingly, Pandu had wounded them. Before breathing his last, the sage cursed Pandu. You have killed me and my wife, so I curse you that you will die when you touch your wife. Hearing these words of the sage, Pandu was worried and anxious. Because of his worrying and anxious, he began to feel ill. He was ill mentally and physically too. His illness also created a big problem, because with his illness, if he could die, there will be no heir to the Kuru dynasty. So Pandu went to live in the forest with his wife. For the entire time of his life, he began to meditate and chant the name of the Lord. One day, Kunti told Pandu about the divine mantra given to her by sage Durvasa. Pandu said that he would love to have children by the help of the divine mantra. So Kunti chanted the mantra and got 3 sons, Yudhishthira, Bhima, Arjun. Then she gave the divine mantra to Madri, who got 2 sons, Nakula, Sahadeva. These children came to be known as the Pandavas, the sons of Pandu. Yudhishthira, the first son of Kunti, was born invoking Dharmaraja. Yudhishthira means the one who remains firm in a battle. The second son, Bhima, was born invoking Vayu, the wind god. He was so strong and energetic. While the wind god Vayu was giving baby Bhima to Kunti, the baby slipped from his hands and fell on the ground on a stone. But the baby Bhima was safe and the stone broke into pieces. Because of his unstoppable hunger, he was also known as Vikrudura, the one with a stomach like a wolf. The third son, Arjun, was born invoking Lord Indra, the king of gods. He grew up to become an AC archer. Arjun was also called as Prat, the son of Prita. Arjun could shoot arrows with both hands, so his name was also called as Savyasachi. Sri Krishna fondly called him Kantaya, the son of Kunti. Madri's two sons, Nakula and Sahadev, were born invoking the Ashwini Kumars, the twin gods. The Ashwini Kumars were expert in the medical science. They were the most handsome of all the gods. The Nakula and Sahadev were as good looking as the Ashwini Kumars. Nakul became prophet in horse riding and Sahadeva was an expert in astrology, but he never predicted anything unless he was asked to do. Thank you everyone, I'll continue in the next video.